Our project is called Maji. Maji means water in Swahili, and Swahili is the national language of Uganda. Our project aims to bring easily accessible clean water to the refugee communities in Uganda through solar power technology.
Uganda is 80% sunshine, and so we can use that energy, the sun energy, to draw water from the ground.
Soya, sorghum, and maybe beans on the side.
One of the reasons we decided to go with the solar-powered water tank is because it's sustainable and the cost of maintenance is very low.
The focus of the project is to bring water to people who do not have it. Without water, there's no life.
Easily accessible clean water is just a basic human right. And so the fact that there are people right now in the world who struggle to have it is just unacceptable.
Both from refugee families, Martin and Leia share a common bond. They have a deep understanding of the challenges refugee camps face every day.
I live in a refugee camp and I know what it is like to have these needs that are not being fulfilled.
The secondary objectives of our project are agricultural training and first aid medical training. So Martin will be spearheading the agricultural training and I'll be doing the first aid medical training.
We are trying to build into the way that people would be supporting themselves without us. And so this kind of independence that we are trying to cultivate in the farmers.
We hope for the water tank installation to be successful, to be sustainable for this community. And hopefully Maji will continue to grow.
One of the main vision that we have is that, you know, this is not just about Olua camp. We hope that some other people will be able to copy what we are doing and spread it across the refugee camps and hopefully the communities in Uganda.
Martin and Leia embody Penn's focus on addressing real-world problems on a global scale. They're passionate about providing tools and training that can vastly improve quality of life for those most in need.
This project will push their limits in so many ways. And I think by the end of the process, they will see the world very, very differently.
I think it's one of the most fulfilling experiences of my life because it is the time when you do something that is not about you. It is about other people's life. And if you touch somebody's life at the end of the day, that's something, you know, to be grateful for.
If two people could have the ability to help a community of 4,000 people get access to clean water and improve their health, that's an overwhelming responsibility and also privilege that we can't pass up.